Hey guys, hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Guys, welcome back to yet another video. Thank you so much for tuning in. You're very much welcome. Just in case we are figure like I thank you so much for tuning in. You're very much welcome. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, subscribe, like, share, and yeah, man, you guys, I'm gonna be talking about this story, guys, the Soshanguve story, where a 5-year-old was murdered during a hijacking, something like that. I'm told the father just came back home, and I think he was followed by the hijackers. So when he came home, when he just got home, the child ran out, just to, you know, like when you come back home in Ghana, they'll just go out to say mommy or daddy, something like that, you guys. And that is the time where that guy was just hijacked. I think maybe they were waiting for the guy to get home to hijack him, or maybe with customs, they're going to do that by that time. And as you guys know, when the child ran out, they started shooting and all that, you guys. But the father survived. But this 5-year-old was murdered. In fact, he wasn't going with his father. He was just coming inside the house, welcoming his father back home from work, something like that, you guys. So this child was murdered by the hijackers, and yeah, they took off with the buggy whatsoever, and the dad survived. The child was taken to hospital and did not make it. So now the story is trending. I see also people complaining about the politicians who are kind of like are trying now. People saying they're trying to campaign using the story. You guys, I mean, we know Develevelama voters so daily. I've seen Umbuyiseni Dlozi around, you guys, addressing the media about it. I've seen Gaetan McKenzie of the Patriotic Alliance, and people are saying, really, do you really have to use this the passing of a child to campaign? It's kuningi, you guys, but I'm so heartbroken. They had to murder such a small baby, 5-year-old, you guys. It's so sad, man. So this story is actually trending for now because, yeah, man, and the Soshanguve residents, they are losing hope when it comes to winning the battle against the crime. I think crime, that side, for me, I'll say crime everywhere. It's just so sad. The way people are being murdered nowadays is just so sad, you guys. It's just too much. It's too much. And I did not know why. So now this 5-year-old boy was gunned down during this hijacking, you guys. Such a small, cute boy. Imagine, you guys, I think Ditebogo Jnr. It's really sad. So the story is Lapanaka Savetan Live Langs of Scupa Corner. They are saying residents of crime written Soshanguve, north of Pretoria, where a 5-year-old boy was gunned down during a hijacking, say they have lost hope of winning the battle against crime. Now they were speaking to the Soweten on Sunday. Residents told of how the rise in cost of living had led them to cancel community patrols to deal with crime, Jack Pella, you guys. However, the residents said when they were patrollers, thugs would shift their focus to other areas, which led them to abandon the patrols on top of a lack of funds to pay the patrollers. You know, so when we patrolled this section, criminals would commit crimes in the other section. Should be able to my patrollers and a coupe, so they just oppose them. When they're this side, they go that side. When they're that side, they go that side. You know what I mean? So, and when we shifted the focus to the area where they were, they would go to the other section that we were not patrolling. They wait for us to go to work, then get into our homes. A gun sound in this place is something that does not shock, they said. Just imagine, you guys. Now, the Gauteng police spokesperson, Lieutenant Colonel Mavela Masond, on Sunday said they were still searching for these suspects. And an unconfirmed number of armed suspects allegedly hijacked the father's white Toyota buggy and shot a 5-year-old boy who later died in hospital. Now, the family spokesperson, Usem Magwenda, Utena, the boy was just happy to see his father. He rushed out of the house with excitement. Little did he know that he would be shot. The father didn't even resist the hijack. He was cooperating with the criminals. He was rushed to a nearby clinic, but that was where he lost his life. We are not coping as a family. The mother had just welcomed a newborn a few days ago. Imagine less than you guys, and then they made your 5-year-old when you just gave birth to a Yazi Ninja. It's just something else. It's heartbreaking, right? Another resident, Ukhapola Melita, said they live in fear. We used to have our own patrol, but in 2021 we stopped because we couldn't no longer afford to pay the security because our house bonds went up and we opted for voiceless. But we have failed. My children are traumatized because they heard the sound of gunshots. We have tried to fight crime, but we have failed, you guys. So now there is that clip, Yagambo is sending those, you guys, where I'm saying people were complaining with their campaign. Now using this story, the EFF tells members of the media that they will ensure the case of Ditebogo Jnr Phalane on the national agenda until justice is served. Jnr was shot and murdered on Friday during a hijacking. It's just, yeah, ne? Now residents are now calling for crime wardens to be deployed in the area and for visible policing. Politicians visited the Phalane family to offer their condolences on Sunday. The EFF member Umbuyiseni Ndlozi uthena, South Africa is a war zone. There are illicit weapons. People who have been corrupted and hotspots are known, but we don't have deployment in those areas. Why? What are police doing? We've committed and we'll make sure that the case of Jnr remains on the national agenda until justice is served. Now, Action South Africa provincial chairperson Umfunzi Angobeni said that they are embarrassed about the level of crime in that area. Which, I'm a victim of this kind of crime, but materialistic things were lost. You can't compare it to the loss of Jnr. It's very sad. And as Action SA, we will make sure once we are in government that prisoners don't get a parole. Yeah, guys, this thing is very heartbreaking. Of the matter of a little one is so sad, man. And the fact that he wasn't even going with his father. He came out in the house, from the house, right from the inside. Okay, daddy is home. He just ran out of the garage, something like that. I don't know if he went through the garage out or what happened there, you guys. Just to get murdered for welcoming your father home. It's just a sad story, this one, you guys. So now the sad part is that people are seeing the politicians as chancers here to use this story to campaign in Dozabo. I do not know. We see Action SA, we see the Patriotic Alliance, we see EFF in Tuikanjalo, but they are saying crime in that area especially is just, it's a mess. Like ukuthi makungathiwa the gunshot is something normal nje mawuzwa nje uqhuma kwesibhamu, it's normal ukuthi naso saqhuma, so ujwayele. You guys just imagine that. May this little one soul rest in peace, you guys. Share, man. Imagine dying, being happy. You are happy for your day to kitchimela ngaphandle. Yeah, your dad is home, then you just pass. Imagine that, you guys. And for them to murder a little one, I'm so mad at them. Mabatholakala, you guys, may they rot in jail and in hell as well. How dare you do that, man? Whether they did it mistakenly, they were not aiming at the child, or they were aiming at the child very, very because they were hijacking, we do not know. Either of them, you guys, may they be found and rot in jail. Imagine this one. Imagine the trauma in that family, and the mother just gave birth to another baby. Now she loses another one. And imagine the father, and he's shot. Imagine it, trauma. Kuleyamden, you guys. Oh, man. May his soul rest in peace, you guys. Hey, she says you're teenager, but okay, you guys, please like this video, subscribe, and yeah, let us meet again on my next one. Sad, man.